Man, what an obnoxious product name, huh? This is my second 4K capture device review from this group that I got sent all at once. I previously reviewed the Elgato 4K 60 Pro, a PCIe 4X capture card. This tiny USB dongle is the Magewell USB Capture HDMI 4K Plus. This is a lot more of a flexible device than Elgato's option, but the lack of pure 4K 60 recording doesn't make it live up to the same level. I'm EplesVox, here to make tech easier and more fun, and I love capture cards, which is hopefully shown by just how many I have reviewed. I was stoked to get to review Magewell's 4K USB offering, especially given how many comments and times people have asked about USB solutions following my 4K 60 Pro review. Magewell is also letting me give away one of these soon, so if you're watching this in 2017, keep an eye on my Twitter for details. I'm also giving away an Intel Core i7-8700K over there, so go tweet it up. I've had a kind of roller coaster experience with this capture device. At first I was super stoked for the possibilities of such an awesome capture dongle, but then was bummed once I realized its limitations, and now I'm fairly evened out, happy with what it can do. I just wish it was a little bit cheaper. This dongle costs $450, which is affordable in the 4K capture space, but given that it can't actually record 4K 60, which I will cover on in a bit, it feels a little bit pricey, but these kinds of devices are always super pricey. This is a USB 3.0 device with a small, quiet fan to keep it cool. It's got a nice design and is quite well built. On one end, you have the HDMI 2.0 input and pass-through output, and on the other, you have 3.5mm headphone jack, microphone jack, and a full-size USB 3.0 port for the included male-to-male cable. One neat feature that you might notice here is that the Magewell 4K USB blah 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 can act as a USB sound card. Within an OBS studio or your favorite recording program, you'll have access to different audio devices for the HDMI input sound, the microphone input sound, and your system sound if you have that running to the headphone jack. Pretty neat. Plugging in headphones also gives you a direct, no latency output of your HDMI audio. It's basically got a little mixer built in, or if you need to run the HDMI audio to your existing mixer, this is a good extractor if you're already using the capture card. They have a capture utility, although it doesn't actually capture anything, which I'll touch on later, and this lets you adjust the volume levels and mix those appropriately as well. With a 600 mHz chip to process the HDMI, I would have hoped it supported more, but I haven't had a whole lot of luck with the high refresh rate support. I was able to push 1080p at 120Hz with the card, but neither 144Hz and neither 120 or 144Hz at 1440p seems to work. On the spec page, it says it can capture up to 120fps below 1080p and 90fps at 1080p. But in OBS Studio, you can't choose a frame rate over 60fps, and in the newer versions, you can't manually type in a frame rate, so I don't know. But if you're running a 120Hz display, you might be alright. I have a 144Hz panel coming in soon for testing, where I can experiment with this further, and I'm excited to test all of these again with a proper high refresh setup. Now, apparently, you can import custom EDID settings, much like the 4K 60 Pro, to allow up to 1440p 144Hz to be an input signal for the card, but the custom EDID stuff can get pretty messy and complicated, and I'm just going to wait until I have a proper monitor to truly test that out. The product also lists support for Rec 2020 and wide color gamut, which are required for HDR. But my PS4 Pro does not detect any HDR support from this device. It would only pass through HDR, not capture it, but that would be a desirable feature if it worked. I have minimal experience with this and no actual HDR displays just yet. I just ordered a TV for it, so I can't test this further right now, but from what I can tell, PS4 Pro HDR doesn't work. Otherwise, you can send a 60Hz signal through at up to 4K. 3840x2160 or 4096x2160 works, but USB 3.0 does not have enough bandwidth to support an uncompressed 4K 60 signal. If you try to pull a 4K signal from the card, it's limited to 30fps. I have a sample here, and unfortunately it's a really, really good match that kind of got ruined. You can see it's not even quite 30fps. The bandwidth limits it and it can't sustain the frame rate. This is where Magewell's typically other included features come in very handy though. The card has an onboard deinterlacer, scaler, and so on. So drop the resolution of the device in OBS down to 1080p and you get a super smooth and super sharp 60fps video feed. I tried doing 1440p, but that didn't quite seem to be 60fps either, which is why I'm skeptical of the high refresh 1440p support. This may sound awful, but it could actually work really well for a lot of people. The advantage of something like this card is that your own PC hardware does not need to do the scaling. So if you're just trying to stream your 4K input and don't actually need a 4K signal being sent out to your stream or recording, just processed from end to monitor, this is perfect. You can create a 1080p or 720p canvas and perform really well, even on some higher end laptops. Or considering the fact that most PS4 Pro and some Xbox One X games aren't even running at a native 4K, you could jerry-rig the recording setup. I also did some testing of setting the PS4 Pro to 4K output, setting the Magewell to scale down to 1080p, and then setting OBS to upscale back to 4K at a large bitrate with NVENC, and the results are very impressive. Unless you're directly comparing, no one would know the difference on YouTube if you were actually capturing 4K or not with this method. Daisy chaining the 4K 60 Pro and the Magewell card together, since Amazon seems to have lost my HDMI splitter shipment, shows that, of course, the 4K 60 Pro at 4K is a tad bit sharper in some areas in the final 4K result, but you only really notice it in a significant way when you zoom into like 600 times to look at text, especially small red text. The native 4K Elgato capture is sharper than the Magewell scaled capture, but beyond that, it looks amazing still, even from this. No blocking or artifacting or anything like that. Plus, you can do this with many more setups due to it being USB. This sense of flexibility also extends to supporting non-standard input signals, such as the 5x line doubling mode from the open source scan converter, allowing me to create stunning 4K 60fps recordings of PlayStation 1 games that look better than most emulator setups while still using original hardware. The Elgato 4K 60 Pro always glitches out when I used with the OSSC and I can't seem to figure out why, so this is pretty handy for a recording setup, especially for some coverage and some projects that I have moving forward. This capture dongle supports Windows 7 and up, Mac OS X 10.9 and up, the new Mac OS 10.12, and Linux, specifically Ubuntu 12.04 and up and CentOS 7 or newer, as well as Chrome OS, with that easy UVC driver that also works with video calling apps. Magewell have also developed a capture utility for Windows, Mac, and Linux that allows you to control volume levels, adjust scaling and cropping, aspect ratios, and using the onboard FPGA processing chips, import custom EDIDs to get up to supposedly 1440p 144Hz pass-through support, convert color spaces, flip and mirror, and update firmware. It's pretty neat. Magewell have made a pretty powerful and flexible device. I really want to see this updated to support USB 3.2 over Type-C and maybe even Thunderbolt 3, though we need to get desktop support for that to take off first so that we can remove some of the bandwidth limitations here. If you need native 4K 60fps raw captures, the Elgato 4K 60 Pro is still a smarter buy, but I really feel like this dongle has a good place on the market. As I mentioned earlier, Magewell will be helping me run a giveaway of this device. Once available, I'll have a link to the giveaway linked in the description down below and the comment section. But otherwise, just keep an eye on my social media, specifically Twitter, and you'll see an update there. As always, Amazon and B&H affiliate links will be in the description below if you want to check out these products I've been talking about for yourself. Like the video if you liked it, get subscribed for more awesome tech videos, and I will catch you in the next one. Epos Vox is a Patreon-supported production. Our videos would simply not be possible without the support and generosity of our patrons, whom you can see on screen now. If you'd like to join the inner circle and get early access to videos, among other benefits, go to patreon.com/eposvox to learn more.